The accusations are serious and false, and they will be handled in a manner reflective of those facts. And that's all I'm gonna say about it. UConn question.
How much of a shock was it to hear about that yesterday once it came out?
Well, UConn?
About Jim Sturt's allegations.
They're gonna be handled. They're not gonna be handled right here, and they're not gonna be handled in a manner that they were dealt. They're gonna be handled in the right manner. I mean, our fans are great. You know, they're loyal, they're passionate, they understand basketball. You know, they understand, you know, how to act in the stands. And, you know, if I could uproot them and put them in every women's basketball arena, every coach that represent that particular fan base will be tremendously proud of what they bring to the table. And I stand by our fans. I stand by, you know, what they represent. I stand by how they cheer. I stand by every single thing that they bring to the building, because it's appropriate and it's well within the game rules.
You know, I'll just say, surrounding the situation that we had to deal with the last few days, I was very confused. I felt very strongly about what we stand for here at this university in women's basketball, our fan base, our head coach, and the way we handle our business and have handled our business over the years. And some things were said that were very confusing. And, you know, we had an incident, so-called, that we needed to check out. We did. We did not find evidence or confirmation that that happened. But you do have things happen in your stadium from time to time that doesn't involve players or coaches. But we addressed those. And as I said, we didn't get any confirmation on that either, with seven people that were very closely involved in the situation. That being said, I was very confused that Coach Staley was addressed from Jim Sturt's comments. I still don't quite understand exactly what the intent was. He and I have spoken yesterday, and we've spoken today. And I'm hoping that there's a resolution coming in some form or fashion.
Did he offer any kind of apology or said that he misspoke, anything like that? What was the text of that combo?
I don't think that it would be professional to share that conversation, but, you know, we have known each other for a little while now, since he joined the SEC as the athletic director at the University of Missouri, and we've addressed it, we've talked about it. He's shared some things with me, and I've shared some things with him. And then later came the comment that was related to Coach Staley and her involvement. I don't quite understand what that was meant to say. I understand what she's done here, and she's built a tremendous program and a fan base and a passionate fan base. And we've won at a high level. We won the last game of the year. We've won a lot of games in the SEC. So I'm extremely proud of what Coach Staley has meant to this program, and she's meant just as much off the floor. Opinions, the thing that's most important to me is that Coach Staley is comfortable with where it goes, and the things that were said, and that she's comfortable in where we end up in the next few hours, the next couple of days with this. That's the most important thing to me. But I do believe a retraction is necessary from Jim Sturt's comments.
Ray, it wasn't too long ago that you had your own, we said, they said, fact-finding mission involving racial slurs in football. How difficult is it to balance that line of fact-finding, finding the truth, and being supportive of your side of the argument?
I believe in facts, but I believe in ownership. And when something happens, you have to own it. I'm in a position to own it. I'm not afraid to own anything that happens, and I believe that's the way things should be done.